Bam, bam, da 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 da, bam, bam, da.
Hey, what's up, guys? My name's Christine, and if you clicked on this video, you know that this is the June episode of Battle of the Books. Battle of the Books is a series that I'm doing on our channel this year where I ask three creators, one from Bookstagram, one from BookTok, and one from BookTube, to give me a recommendation. And then throughout the month, I read these three books, rate them via the Kaupal method, which was introduced to me by Book Roast, created by Book Roast. All hail Book Roast. Links down below if you're interested. And then the winner, or the person with the highest Kaupal, wins that month's round. The idea is that by the end of the year, the platform with the most points is going to be the platform that recommended the best books of this year. To me, at least. Each month, I try and do a different genre or a different theme. This month, of course, it's June, so we are going to be doing Pride. We are reading every gay book we can get our hands on. So I'm really excited. I feel like I have some really great creators, and I can't wait to see what they recommended me. So far, every single platform is on the board, and it is neck and neck. It's halfway through the year, so I know the stakes are high, because once we start getting into the later half of the year, it's gonna be getting down to the nitty gritty. Now I would like to introduce to you our creators for this month. The first person that I want to introduce to you is going to be a person that will be representing BookTok today. He is honestly one of my favorite creators. Like, I remember following him a while ago, like years ago, and just being like, wow, the energy here is just so great, so immaculate. And then of course from there we kind of like DM'd each other and got to know each other, and now we're actually running a, you know, Pride-a-thon Instagram bingo board for this month together. But I just really, really love him and think that he's just such a ray of sunshine on the internet. So it is Greg from Just Greggy on TikTok. And if you guys are not following him, you need to go ahead and get on over there and click the follow button. He's also on Instagram too, if you guys are interested. But today, for our purposes, he will be recommending from BookTok, or recommending for BookTok. So I'm really excited to see what he's gonna be recommending me. If I had to guess, I mean, it could be anything under the sun, honestly, but I feel like it's gonna be a YA, LGBTQ, obviously, themed book. I just don't know what YA it's gonna be, because I can't say that I'm well-versed in YA. Yeah, I can't say that I'm well-versed. Whatever he recommends me, I know it's gonna be fun, so let's go ahead and get into the video.
Hi, Christine. Thank you so much for picking me for this. I have not been so active because I am busy working on my bachelor's thesis, so I've been on a short hiatus, but I will take a break and do anything bookish if I have the chance. So for your recommendation, I was really thinking of, okay, what is something that Christine would like that I also read a lot of? And obviously it's not going to be anything from this section, you know, if you just forget that. Now instead I thought, okay, you like a lot of fantasy books, so I would recommend you something in the range of fantasy with some very slight romance from an author that you are familiar with. Without any further ado, the book I've picked for you is The Sunbearer Childs by Aidan Thomas. I finished this recently, and I mean recently in the loosest context, and essentially it's just Hunger Games but queer, mixed with a lot of Latinx themes, and it is beautifully written, it is amazing, and I think you are going to love it. I hope you enjoy this as much as I did, and may the gods be ever in your favor.
Oh my god, I've been wanting to read this book for so long! Wow, that's such a good rec, Greg. Thank you so much. Wow. Wow. I just remember when the promo for this book came out, and I was just like in love with all the characters. I was like, wow, everyone is awesome. Everyone's stunning. I want all the character artwork. Like, something's wrong with me. Like, I'm just a visual person. I also just love the color of this book. And while Cemetery Boys wasn't my favorite story because I wanted more from it, I did like the writing style. And I think Aidan Thomas is really gonna bring it with the second book of the Cemetery Boys, like duology, trilogy, or like whatever it's gonna be, series. So I'm willing to give Aidan a second chance, okay? I'm willing to give Aidan a second chance because, now I didn't rate it horrible. Like, let's just say that, okay? I just wanted other things to happen in the story. So I'm excited for Sunbearer Trials. I feel like this was highly anticipated on my TBR. And yes, everybody, it was a YA. So I was correct. The next person that I want to talk about is actually one of my book besties. She is an icon living. I love her so much. She's always like the A1 organized. Like I remember when I first followed her on YouTube, I was like, wow, this person has it together. Okay. She's got all of her planned videos. She has great recommendations. Everything she tells me to read, I always love it. So it's gonna be kind of hard, I think, to compete with her, honestly, because I feel like she knows the creme de la creme, okay, of book recommendations. I feel like she's just, it's gonna be hard to beat her. It's gonna be hard to beat her. And that is my good friend, Jess, from Books Past Bedtime. She is going to be representing YouTube, like I said. And if I had to guess, like, you know, back in the day, I would have said she would have recommended me some kind of like fluffy romance, but she's been really getting into smut recently. And I'm talking like it's been months and months and months, and she's been reading some really good smut books. So like if I had to think of what she would recommend me, I would say it's gonna be something obviously gay and smutty. I'm not sure, because it's like she's on this Kindle Unlimited plane, you know what I mean? That's just going up, 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 up. She's got the recommendations. I don't even know what it could be, but if I had to say something, I would say it's smutty, okay? So that's what I think she's gonna recommend me. Like I said, I have no idea what the book is gonna be, but let's see. Let's see what she actually recommends.
Hi, Christine. First off, I just wanna say thank you so much for inviting me to be a part of this iconic video series, especially during Pride Month. And it literally couldn't be any more perfect because I'm relaunching my channel after a 5-month hiatus this month. So literally,
I'm so excited
to be a part of this, and I'm so excited. Thank you so much. I am so excited to see what you guess that I'm going to recommend you. I feel like it could go either way. Like, I feel like you could be spot on guessing what I'm going to recommend, or you could be like totally unsure, especially because I've been on kind of a hiatus, so I don't know if you like know my like super recent favorites.
Absolutely not.
I might go in a like Kindle Unlimited direction as well, because I know that you have read and really liked two of my Kindle Unlimited recommendations, but that is not the direction I'm going to go in. Because the book I'm actually going to recommend for you is A Strange and Stubborn Endurance by Foz Meadows. Now, this is a queer high fantasy male-male romance that I read last year and absolutely loved. It was one of my favorite books of 2022, and I really think it just underhyped, and I want more people to read it, and I really want you to read it because I feel like we will love it for some of the same reasons. This book follows Vel and Kay, who come from very different worlds, and they are thrown together in an arranged political marriage. They're complete strangers. They don't know each other. They don't trust each other, but they have to come to terms with being in close proximity to one another, and they kind of come to find that they are each other's saving grace, the only people they can really trust, as this big political plot starts to unfold and someone is trying to take out Kay. Christine, I really think you will love this one because it has a slow burn romance that is at the caliber of The Cruel Prince. I know that's a high praise, high thing to say, but it really has the same vibes. These two are definitely sweeter to each other than Jude and Cardin are, but the like slow burn nature of the romance and how it develops over time over the course of the book is very similar, and it like made me scream and squeal in the same way. So I hope it does you as well. And I also really think you will like this fantasy world. It's such an interesting fantasy world. There's not really magic, but it is set in like a different world with different kingdoms and high political intrigue. I feel like that's something that you would not expect for me to like, but I just need a queer slow burn romance in the background to really invest me in the political intrigue in a book. So this is what I'm recommending to you. I can't wait to see what you think of it, and I really hope you love my recommendation, and I hope I win.
I do love that recommendation, Jess. As she always does, I think she's nailed it on the head, because if I know anything about myself, if you've got high fantasy, politics, and some kind of love story, it doesn't even have to really be much, okay? It could be just a little sprinkle in there. I'm gonna be squealing, I'm gonna be throwing up, I'm gonna be throwing the book out the window, because I will not be able to handle it, okay? It's just gonna be so cute. And the fact that she said it's like The Cruel Prince, like, yes, that is a lot of pressure, but if it's coming from Jess, who is like a close friend, a confidant, I feel like she knows what she's talking about. Wow, awesome. Okay, that's great, because that is not a book that I would have ever picked for myself. Like, I've seen that book before, but I didn't know what it was about. Also, I should have said male-male freaking romance, because she always recommends me male-male romances. Ugh, I knew that was gonna be it. But wow, I think that's the perfect storm, honestly. That sounds like a really fun time. Okay. Oh, wow, I can't wait. All right, so the next creator that I want to introduce to you all, I'm very excited to introduce because they are actually the creator of the Trans Rights Readathon on Instagram. If you guys don't know what this readathon is, it was definitely a fun time to celebrate the trans community and read a bunch of books written by trans authors centered around trans stories to make other people aware of what's going on with the trans community and like trans rights and just everything that's happening with that. And I feel like it started out as like this small thing and it just kind of like blew up. I think it actually maybe started on TikTok and then went to Instagram. I'm not sure, okay? All I know is that it literally became this huge readathon, and you can look it up on Sim's actual Instagram, which is Sim_bookstagrams_badly. But yeah, Sim is just so cool. And I was like, okay, if I have the opportunity to get a really cool book rec from someone who has definitely made a difference in the community, then I am going to reach out and see if I can get this done. Also, Sim is an author, so definitely check that out if you guys are interested. But I truly don't know what could be the recommendation for this. Like, I honestly, I'm not sure. I don't know. I can't pretend to know, okay? All I know is that I'm excited. I don't know what it could be, but I'm thinking it's gonna be a good recommendation. So let's just see what Sim has in store for me. Let's go. Okay, sorry about that, y'all. I had to get my iPad out because I couldn't look at it on my phone. I don't know what's going on. My phone was like unsupported file type. All right, here we go.
Christine, my Pride Month pick for you is Mariama J. Lackington's Forever Is Now. Mariama is the author of 2 MG books. I read very little MG, and what I read, I enjoy even less. But I absolutely loved and read in one sitting and cried at and am obsessed with Mariama's last 2 MG books. And Forever Is Now is her YA debut, and so I'm just so excited for it and for supporting Mariama. She's a delightful member of like the online author community. She's on TikTok and Instagram, and her books have scooped up like every single starred review, all kinds of awards, and I just think I would love to see more of her work on Instagram and TikTok, and I'm really excited about reading Forever Is Now and hearing what you think of it.
All right, let me look this up because I have never seen this book in my life. All right, Forever Is Now. A poignant and lyrical young adult novel in verse about a black teen coming of age in an anxiety-inducing world from the author of For Black Girls Like Me and In the Key of Us. I'm safe here, that's how Sadie feels, on a perfect summer day wrapped in her girlfriend's arms. School's out, and even though she's been struggling to manage her chronic anxiety, we love neurodivergent rep. Sadie is hopeful better times are ahead, or at least she thought she was safe, when her girlfriend reveals, oh no. Oh, unexpected news and the two witness a violent incident of police brutality unfold before them. Sadie's whole world is up in it in an instant. I'm not safe anywhere. That's how Sadie feels every day after, vulnerable, uprooted. She retreats inside as the weeks slip by and relies on her phone to stay connected to the outside world. When Sadie's therapist gives her a diagnosis for her debilitating panic, agoraphobia, she starts on a path of acceptance and healing. Meanwhile, Sadie's best friend Evan updates her on the protests taking place in their city. Sadie wants to be a part of it, to use her voice and affect change, but how do you show up for your community when you can't even leave your house? I can build a safe place inside myself. That's what Sadie learns over the course of one life-changing summer. With some help from her family, her best friend, an online platform for activists, and a magnetic crush she develops for the new boy next door. From Stonewall Honor-winning author Mariama J. Lackington comes Forever Is Now, a powerful young adult novel in verse about mental health, love, family, black joy, and finding your voice and power in an unforgiving world. Well, that sounds like it's going to be a good time. Definitely coming of age YA novel, and the cover is stunning. The cover is stunning. Whew, okay, well, I'm not sure how... I think the one in verse that I've read is Clap When You Land. And I think that's the only one that I've read like that off the top of my head. Read off the top of my head. Am I a poet and I didn't even know it? I gotta get out of here. All right, so those are our 3 picks for this vlog. I'm really excited to get into these because I probably wouldn't have picked these just off the bat. Well, let me not say that because Sun Bearer Trials was on my TBR. It was on my TBR. But as we know, I'm on a book buying ban, so I haven't actually bought a book for myself in so long because I just can't seem to get a bingo. We'll see how it goes. Anyway, I don't know what I'm going to be reading first, but I'm excited to get into this vlog with you guys. And yeah, let's get started. Okay, y'all, jump scare. All right, so I have gotten to the 50% of A Strange and Stubborn Endurance by Foz Meadows. So I don't know if it's because I'm reading this at the same time as like me reading the book for Fantasy Over Everything, because we're also reading A Taste of Golden Iron right now. But these books like go hand in hand. Like they're giving me like the same energy. Also, like, if you read this book and you read A Taste of Golden Iron, it's also the same energy as like Winter's Orbit. Okay, I hope that's making sense. What I mean though is that our main character in this one is very like anxious. Okay, he's very anxious and, you know, is feeling like he's unwanted in his, like, where he comes from, basically. So the plot of this one, did I even talk about the plot of this one? Essentially, this man gets kicked out of his, like, hometown. All right, we're going to put it in modern terms, okay? He gets kicked out of his hometown because his dad finds him with another man, okay? And his dad was going to put him in an arranged marriage with a woman, but then because he found out about this, and also there was, like, a representative from, like, this woman's, you know, hometown, this other hometown, the representative was like, oh, well, we'll just do an arranged marriage with, like, the son of our nation and your son. So it'll be like, you know, two men instead of a man and a woman. And the dad got pissed. He got pissed because this apparently is like, I'm seeing a parallel between like, just like kind of like conservative white, you know, culture. That's what it's giving for our main character. Like, he's coming from that kind of a culture. Okay, so his dad is so mad. He's like, you are gonna go get married and we're gonna have this alliance, but you are not welcome back here. Okay, don't ever come back. So anyway, that's happening. All right, fast forward. He gets to the nation, the other nation. There ends up being a murder. Okay, this is not spoilery. This is like the general plot, right? There's a murder in the building, okay? And he almost gets killed. It was wild. I was like, oh my God, this man's gonna be murdered in the first 50%. So then now they've got to figure out, we've got the one plot, you know what I mean? Like him and his daddy. But now there's a murder. So now they're all like, who is trying to kill my man? Who's trying to kill the main character? So, you know, as that's going, he's building this relationship with, you know, his lover, with his fated betrothed. So the murder in the building, what had happened? Oh, arranged marriage. So now, while all this is happening, they're also trying to forge a relationship together. They decide to be friends. They decide to be friends, okay? And the tension is building. They do these cute little things together. You know, there's another point at which our main character's life gets threatened. This other man, who is the other, you know, love interest from the new place, the new hometown, he is like a soldier of sorts. So he's out here trying to fight for his the love of his life's life. You know, he's out here having to defend him, whatever. He's the crown duke. I would assume it's like the crown duke because they have words in this one where it's not like, you know, prince and princess and like duke and whatever. They've got like different words for that. So that's a little confusing, I'm not gonna lie. But overall, I'm enjoying it, okay? This was so chaotic, this check-in. I hope it's making sense. Anyway, they're cute. I mean, we're at the 50, nothing too spice-alicious has happened, but, you know, this might not be that kind of a book. I don't know what kind of a book this is. I'm not really sure. Murder mystery, fantasy, LGBTQ+, you know, I don't know if it's gonna be spice-alicious. We'll see. Anyway, so I'm enjoying it. That's the point of this check-in. I'm enjoying it. We'll see what happens. I'll tell you about the rest of my day. So I have today off. So I'm gonna be finishing this book and hopefully starting the next one, which is Forever Is Now. And tonight my friends are surprising me for my birthday. Okay, my birthday already happened. That's already happened, but this is like the weekend after. So my friends are taking me to some something. I don't know what they're doing. No idea. So that's going to be the BTS for this role, for this battle of the books. It's going to be fun. I'm excited. And yeah, I can't tell you much more than that. That's tonight. So I'll do a check-in later, let you guys know what's going on with this book. Hopefully I finish it today. I'm sure I will. I have nothing else to do. And yeah, that's it. That's the vibe. More concise thoughts later. See ya. All right, so it has been some time today. I have finished A Strange and Stubborn Endurance. Okay, I have finished that book. And I will say that I love it when the book has the title in the book, but it doesn't distract you from the plot of the book. Our main character, I really like him. I really like him. Okay, he's a little, entitled sometimes. Yeah, we'll go with entitled. But he has a good heart and he's pretty smart. He figures out a lot of stuff in this book. So yeah, I feel like the plot twist was, I wasn't necessarily anticipating the plot twist. I didn't really know where this book was going. I was just here for the ride. I was here for the ride and I was here for the vibes. And it was a good time. I really liked it. It'll be interesting to see what the call pile is. And I am interested if this is gonna win. Like, I don't know if it will. But I did really like it. I will say this book is kind of written in like, almost not in old English, okay? It's not like, oh, hear ye, but it's definitely not, you know, a modern day language. Like, the author took their time with this one. So there's that. And I did like the relationship between the main character and his mans. There was a jealousy trope in there at one point. That was fun. I have told y'all and told y'all and told y'all, like, y'all want to give me a book with a jealousy trope? It is on like Donkey Kong. I love it. So that was cute. You know, they had their moments, they had their thing. This is also like the reason why I think it's so similar to A Taste of Gold and Iron is because there's also an ex in here that is like friends with his ex. You get what I'm saying? Like, the exes are friends. And I never see that in a book, but that also happened in A Taste of Gold and Iron. So I'm just like, these are very similar stories. They're lining up. They're lining up. But yeah, so that was interesting to have kind of like that dynamic in there. Because usually, you know, the ex is giving the jealousy. All right? You know what I'm saying? There's also, I forgot to mention this, but there's also some disability representation because we have a mute character. Hello! So we're just having a great time with that. He speaks not ASL, obviously, because they're not American, but they speak a sign language, him and the main character, because they're friends. They're like besties. So that's really cool. I like how that is like put in there. Other than that, the pining was there. The pining and the cuteness was there. It was a good time. I really liked it. And I enjoyed the plot of this one. That's done. We'll talk about the call pile at the end. Y'all know the deal. But overall, good feeling, good vibes. I did tell you guys I started Forever Is Now. I got that one from the library. And that one, let's see where I am. I want to say like 20% into this book. And I think I'm going to pause it for now. I'm just not feeling this book. It's definitely a coming of age, and it is about this young girl who has like a lot of anxiety, so much so that like she's got agoraphobia, which is where you like don't want to leave your house because everything is just overwhelming to you. And the reason why I'm not feeling it is because it's kind of triggering my anxiety a little bit, just kind of reading about this girl's experience. And it's not something that I really want to read right now. It's a pause for now for sure. So I'm going to try and pick it up after I start. What is that one called? The Sunbearer Trials, I think, is the next one. So I'm gonna pause it for now. And I'm a start getting ready to go to this event with my friends. But yeah, I all I can say about it is that she's got such high anxiety. She describes every little thing she's anxious about. And in her describing these things, it's like making me aware of the things that I am anxious about. And so it's like triggering me a little bit. So I think maybe if I didn't do my own therapy work and like hadn't really discovered that like I'm an anxious person and also like everything else that's like different about me, if I wasn't at that level, like if I was younger and hadn't discovered those things about myself, I think this book would be really helpful in kind of like highlighting these things and like these resources of like going to a therapist and like talking about the if you're worried about XYZ, you know, talking about it with your therapist is great because you can figure out ways to like combat that anxiety and that kind of a thing. But just like me being in the kind of like headspace and like age that I'm at right now, it's like I don't need to discover that because I've already discovered it. And so it is kind of like triggering a little bit because it's like putting me back into those feelings of when I first like discovered that I was anxious and like first discovered I was neurodivergent and kind of like the helplessness that came about me because I didn't really know like where to go or what to do or like how to fix myself. You know what I mean? So reading about her experience is just hard. It's hard. And I am going to pause for now because I don't think that right now I want to put myself in that headspace and also try and like go have fun with my friends. You know what I mean? So anyway, that's what I'm doing. So that means the next book that I'll start will be The Sunbearer Trials. I'm really excited for that one. It's going to be like The Hunger Games, but like make it Latinx and just like all this great like mythology and just like vivid, you know, imagery and colors and like the cover's great. It's just a great looking book. I've been wanting to read it for a while. And I'm excited. So anyway, okay, so I'll check in with that probably in a day or two. I'm not really sure when I'll start that, but I will let you guys know, of course. And in the meantime, enjoy this BTS of me being surprised wherever we're going. Because I don't know. Okay, cool. See you in a little bit. Here we go now. Batman scoop on the mic. Mix in the mix on the real steel. This is what I was fucking born to do. Next, let's go. Okay guys, so I'm officially 50% into the Sunbearer Trials. First of all, the cover. Beautiful! Shout out to Stephanie from Stephanie Bookish for giving me this book. So yeah, I'm at 50%. It's the 190 page mark. And these are my thoughts. So the pros. First of all, the world, the atmosphere, everything is vivid, colorful, so well thought out. The mythology of this world is so interesting, and every single character has their own characteristics, their own like powers, because of course we have like all of these different gods and goddesses, dios and deesses, and everything is just so well like separated, but also together in this world. I think probably the strongest thing about this book is the atmosphere and the world building. Hey, buddy. Just because clearly Aiden put in a lot of thought with that. Why does this always happen? Why does this always happen when I sit here? So yeah, that also, the rep in this book is really, really good. We don't have just like one trans main character. We have a few, while also representation for, I would say, like pan rep, and you know, just people kind of loving who they want to love. It's not that big of a deal in this world. And yeah, there aren't any issues, you know what I mean? Like obviously there are still the kind of like growing up issues, you know, coming of age issues, where like you're young and you're trying to figure yourself out as a young adult, but you know, no one is trying to kill anybody or hurt anyone because of their, you know, preferences and also just who they are in general. So that's another plus. The cons, I think we'll get into this one. I feel the same way about Cemetery Boys as I do kind of about this book. Like I'm getting literally the same vibes from the main character. And that's just that the main character is a bit whiny and juvenile at certain points. I know that this is a YA and that it's made for a younger audience, so I'm trying to keep that in mind and not lean too far into those kind of like gripes. But it is something I notice and something that kind of bothers me like as I'm reading. So I did want to mention that. Speaking of Cemetery Boys and this main character, they seem to be like almost exactly the same character. So I'm going to say if you liked Cemetery Boys, you'll probably like this one. Like if you like the main character in Cemetery Boys, I feel like they're very quick to react to things without thinking. They're very like judgmental at times. And a few other things, I think, just like in the character of it, like how the character acts. That main character wasn't my favorite, so you can probably guess this character isn't my favorite. Even though, like, I like it fine enough, I'm just not, like, obsessed with the character, if that makes sense. Having modern elements mixed into the world is a little weird for me, I'm not gonna lie. It does make things, like, really convenient, while also pulling me out of the story. There are, like, replacements for words like Instagram. It's like insto photographia, and then like tack talk, those kind of things. I think if it's like something that you're, for me, if it's something that you're trying to like mimic from the real world, it's like don't use the words that are close to what the real words are, just because that like can take your audience out of everything. So yeah, the modern elements, if it was modern in like a fantasy way where like it's all just like new, like it's not, they don't have an Instagram, they instead have like a, you know, picture, you know, app, whatever, and it's not mentioned or something, I think I probably would have liked that better. But yeah, I am liking like the kind of like Hunger Games elements of it. Like they have all these trials that they have to go to. They're competing because there's only going to be one winner, and then the loser is going to be sacrificed in the end. So I am enjoying the kind of like trial elements of it. So that is a fun part for me. I do think that like one of the characters, Zio, they're like the unlucky character. Like they're like a demigod, you know, a semi-dios. So they are like the youngest person in this game. They don't think that they have powers, but like I have this feeling about them that like they're not giving everyone a full view of who they are, you know what I mean, or who he is. Like he's not revealing something. Like I can just feel it in my bones, so I don't know what that means. I don't think it's a spoiler. but it means something. I don't know. I have a feeling. I have a feeling in my bones. So that, I think, is all I want to say about the 50% check-in. Like, I'm having a fine time. I think the world building and kind of, like, plot of it is fine and fun. Like, very, very fun. That's, like, keeping me in it. But sometimes the writing is stilted with the dialogue and the characters are a little funky sometimes, which is exactly the issue that I had with Cemetery Boys. I think I gave that book a 3.5 or maybe a 3. Anyways, so that's what's going on with the Sun Bear Trials right now. That's my check-in. I'm going to get a lot of reading for this done today, so I will try and finish it and give you guys an update in a little bit. All right, babes, it's time. Let's do our final check-in for the Sun Bear Trials, and, you know, then we'll do a little recap of what's been going on. Okay, so Sun Bear Trials. I really like this book. I think I've said everything that I really want to say about it. There were some twists, some turns, and I think one of the strongest things that Aidan Thomas has in the writing style and just like the repertoire of all of the books is that the plot, okay, the story is very, very strong. This is so imaginative and creative and, like I said, very vivid, and just the world building in this was so good. Like, I had such a good time. I think if you are a fan of The Hunger Games, any kind of like a book where like they have to do trials, then this is gonna be the book for you. I will say that it did get a little long at the end. I think 5 trials was like a little too much for me. I was like, okay, I get it. I get it, we got the trials, but like, what's going on after the trials? You know what I mean? I also think that the little sprinkle of like a romance, it wasn't really a romance. I wouldn't even really call it that. There was an interest, I think, between the two characters. Okay, the two that are supposed to be having a relationship. There was more romance in Cemetery Boys. So go with that with the right expectations, okay? Other than that though, like, I think I stick by what I said. The dialogue is a little stilted, a little naive sometimes, and the main character is very young and naive in some ways, but that might just be because it's like a YA, okay? I think the end was a little rushed. Definitely like the YA trend of we're setting up for a second book, so let's get in everything that we can. I'm just gonna stop my dryer really quick because I feel like that's very loud. Hold on 1 second. Okay, so as I was saying, and I think that is just me. That's my drama. That's my personal thing. I love the story in this, like I said. It's just like they're little things, like little nitpicky things, okay? So that is my final, like, my final thoughts, I guess, on Sun Bear Trials. Overall, I had a really great time, and I think this is such a fun time. So if you're into YA kind of like adventure, like you like the trial trope, definitely pick up this book. I will report that I tried to pick up Forever Is Now again, and my anxiety was just peaking. I just could not finish that book. So that's unfortunately going to be a DNF for me. I'm not going to be able to finish that one because of me. That's my drama. I think if you want to read a coming of age that has political and also climate issues in it, has like anxiety rep, specifically agoraphobia, and it's something that like you want to maybe learn more about on like a personal level, I think that that book will be for you. Unfortunately for me, it's not, so it's gonna knock out Instagram for the running for this one at a DNF. I hate giving DNFs, but you know, sometimes it happens. We're all human. It is what it is. So unfortunately, Sim is out for this round, which means that we have the call pile for 2 other books. So let's go ahead and get into that. All right, so let's get into the call pile of the first book of this vlog, which is going to be A Strange and Stubborn Endurance. This one, like I said, reminded me very much of A Taste of Gold and Iron. But I think I liked this one a little bit better than that book. So if you read that book and you liked that book, definitely pick up this book, okay? I think the main male character in this one, I think he has some really great growth, okay? Because he started out really anxious and quiet, and the anxiety still stayed there throughout the book, but he did have some, like, character growth where he came into himself and, like, figured out kind of like more of who he was as a person without having kind of like the weight of society on his shoulders. I liked that. Okay. I liked that character growth. Also, of course, we're going to like a like warrior, you know, male love interest because he's just over here doing the jealousy trope, you know, protecting his husband, like just being cute on all accounts. So it's going to be an 8 out of 10. The atmosphere in this one, I feel like the atmosphere was, like, all right, but I couldn't, like, clearly see things sometimes. There was a lot of explanation of the world, but, like, I don't know. I still, like, to this day, I'm like, what did the world even look like? You know what I mean? So I think I'm gonna give that one a 7 out of 10. It wasn't anything that, like, bothered me, but it also wasn't anything that was, like, super, like, in your face, if that makes sense. Like, I knew where they were, and I knew where they were traveling and things like that. I just didn't think that the atmosphere was that great, like, that memorable. Here we go. It wasn't that memorable. So I'm gonna be giving it a 6 out of 10. The writing in this one, I enjoyed. It was fine. There was a lot of exposition for the world building, which kind of bogged me down just a little bit sometimes. So I am gonna give it an 8 out of 10 on that. The plot in this one is very interesting because it does start out with on-page sexual assault, which just told me that, but I just like wasn't prepared. It's like in the very beginning of the book, okay? And I'm not even sure if I addressed it like when I was reading it, because as soon as it happened, I was like, ew, and then skip, you know, and then went through like for the rest of the book. So that's like an essential kind of like part of the character building and the plot of this book. Wasn't my favorite. But everything else that happened, I really liked because I liked him kind of like having the arranged marriage, traveling to the other kingdom, and then kind of like this whole plot of like who's trying to kill him, like what is the assassin, or who is the assassin, excuse me, and like, you know, what's going on with that. So that was a lot of fun. I definitely was engaged with it. It's just that first part. That first part, I was like, what's going on in the House of Commons here? So I'm going to be giving it an 8.5 out of 10. The intrigue is going to be an 8.5 as well. It's the same situation. I wasn't putting it down, but did get bogged down sometimes with the plot and the writing, okay? The logic in this one was great. I liked the relationships between the two main male characters. Like, I just thought they were really cute, and by the end of it, they really, like, loved each other. It was not Instagrammy. It was not Insta-lovey at all. And, yeah, I think it all made sense, okay? I will say that the reveal of the assassin was a little cuckoo bananas, okay? That one was a little crazy. Yeah, I still to this day don't even know what happened to them. So, we're gonna give the intrigue and relationships an 8 out of 10. And then overall enjoyment, I think if I had to rate it out of 5 right now, I think I'd probably give it like a 3.5 to a 4, which means that I will be giving it a 7.5. For Sunbearer Trials, all right, here we go. Okay, so starting off for Sunbearer, we're gonna do the characters. The characters, I'm gonna give an 8.5 out of 10. I think the cast of characters was done really well. All of them were individually so unique and written so well. It's just when they interacted with each other, sometimes it would just be a little bit stilted, like the dialogue would be a little off. And of course, like I told you guys, the main character, I think I just had trouble kind of like connecting with Teo just because of some of the naive decisions that were made. And yeah, that's my issue. That's my thing. I think the atmosphere in this was done so well. It's one of the best parts of this book. I think the world building and just kind of like the world that Aiden created, it was so rich, vivid, and beautiful, well thought out, done super, super well. So I'm going to give that a 9.5 out of 10. The writing, I'm going to give an 8 out of 10. Okay, I just don't like some styles that Aiden Thomas does with the dialogue. Some of it, I don't like it. I think, you know, like I said, strongest part is the world building. So it's going to be 8 out of 10. The plot in this one, I liked the plot up until a certain point. Then at like the end of it, some things just started going haywire and it started just kind of like going downhill real fast. And I think that's because Aiden's trying to like set up for the second book. And like, I get that. I understand that. But, you know, we don't have to rush like the final trial and kind of like the wrap up at the end. There were some things that didn't make sense and that even got called out in the book. And without giving any spoilers, it's like there were like two sides, right? And then some people from one side went and like helped the other side. And the other side was like, why are you helping us? You're literally on this side. And the people were like, oh, because we care about this one thing. And I'm like, so why are y'all on a different side then? It doesn't make sense. So that is gonna lead the plot. Okay, that's gonna lead me into the logic, right? And the relationships. I think the logic and the relationships are probably like one of the weakest things about this book. Yeah, that's it. I can't really say much more without saying much more. But I do think that like the main like love relationship, while like I understand it, I don't understand really why it was there projected as like a romantic interest. You know what I mean? Like it was told to us, but like I didn't see it, if that makes sense, in the writing. Okay, the relationship between the friends and kind of like Teo and his mom and then all the other kind of like characters with their parents, like that was fine. So that I'm gonna give a 7 out of 10. The plot, I'm gonna give a 7.5 out of 10 because I did like it. I just, for some reason, I just feel like it could have been a little bit stronger. I feel like it could have been a little bit stronger. Intrigue with this one, I feel like I was interested in the, you know, what was happening throughout the entire book. I feel like I was interested, you know, up until a certain point when I was like, okay, where are we going with this? So I think intrigue, I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10 just to be safe because I don't know. It was like, I was like really, really into it in the first part. And then like the last part, it just kind of, as the plot kind of like started going cuckoo bananas, my intrigue also, I was like, all right, so where are we going with this? Like, what's going on, you know? Overall, I think the enjoyment for Sunbearer is probably like a 3.75. Like, I think it's around the same. Maybe a 4. I'm gonna put 7.5. Because I feel like it's right in the middle. All right. That being said, let's go ahead and tally up all of the numbers. Oh my gosh, this is literally crazy. Okay, so the numbers are in and this is so close. It's killing me right now. Okay, so Strange and Stubborn Endurance gets a 7.9 out of 10, which is right on the top of a 4.5. That's like right there. Like 7.5 is a 4.5 out of 5 stars. Then Sunbearer Trials got an 8 flat. Like 8 flat, which means that it's 0.10 above Strange and Stubborn Endurance. So these two are neck and neck. They're both 4.5s, very low 4.5s, but right on the cusp, right on the cusp. So, I mean, Sunbearer Trials is it. You won, Greg, okay? Congratulations to Greg. You officially won another point for TikTok, which is really blowing my mind right now that TikTok is in the lead for this competition. Like, wow, I kind of can't believe it. Everybody trashes TikTok, but, you know, they're really coming through. Regardless, these two books were very, very close in the running. I think overall, Strange and Stubborn Endurance had a very median score where, like, all of the scores were pretty much the same, whereas Sunbearer Trials definitely had stronger parts to the rating and lower parts to the rating. So there was more of a disconnect there. But of course, the weight is really going to depend on the characters and the plot. Those are my two faves. And of course, Sunbearer Trials did, you know, get a little bit higher in that, which is why the score was a little bit higher in the end. Anyway, regardless, congrats to Greg, and also a big thank you to all the other creators who recommended me books. I know I did DNF this round, but But that's not to say that Forever Is Now is like not the book for you. It's just not the book for me currently in my headspace mentally. And that's on me. That's my drama. So anyway, I just want to say thank you to all of the creators once again for giving me these recommendations and being such great creators. All of their information is going to be linked down below. So I want you guys to do me a favor, go ahead and follow them, watch some of their content, engage, and give them some love, because it takes a lot to recommend books to people. It truly is like putting a little bit of your soul out into the world. And so I want to make sure that you guys are giving them lots of love for this. The current rankings are as follows, with TikTok in the lead. Like I said, it's shocking me. It's shocking me, but this is reality, people, okay? I'm very excited to see you guys next month. We have another fun genre coming up, and I cannot wait for you guys to see it. So thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, I will see you in the next one. Bye! Bum, bum, da 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 da, bum, bum, da.